Lesson 1.3, students put a thermometer in hot water and in cold water and observe the way the red liquid moves up and down. Now, of course, they know that that's what a thermometer does, but in this case, the thermometer is used as sort of a device to show the application of heating increases molecular motion and cooling decreases molecular motion. So they ask the question, what makes the liquid in a thermometer go up and down? Like, on the molecular level, why does that happen? Eventually, they come to understand that heating a liquid causes the particles to move faster. Well, they know that already from Chapter 1, Lesson 2, and that they get a little further apart, and that cooling them makes them move slower and get a little closer together. But now they realize that a thermometer works for exactly those reasons. So what happens in the activity is kids look very closely at the thermometer to see that it contains a liquid, and they put it in hot water and put it in cold water and see what happens. And then they already know that heating a liquid increases molecular motion and that the particles get a little further apart, and the cooling a liquid decreases molecular motion. They get a little closer together. So they begin to make the connection that, oh, that's exactly what is happening in the red liquid in the thermometer. And to sort of reinforce the idea, we have a molecular model animation. It's very similar to the ones that they've seen already, but it shows the relationship between what happens on the molecular level and what they see in the thermometer. So here at room temperature, the particles are moving, and, you know, it's random molecular motion. They're moving past one another, although they're attracted to each other because it's a liquid. It's probably mostly alcohol, but the principles are still the same, that the particles of a liquid are attracted to each other and in motion. So if you put it in hot water, the particles move a little faster, and they get a little further apart, so the red liquid moves up. If you put them in cold water, the particles slow down, get a little closer together, and the liquid moves down the tube. So that's the idea behind the animation, is to give kids a visual representation of what's happening at the molecular level, and they can apply what's happening at the molecular level to their macroscopic observation of the movement of the liquid in the thermometer. Also, you can go to the activity sheet and have kids draw the particles of a liquid in hot water, so they would be a little further apart than the particles in cold water, and they would have more motion lines. In fact, that's why the level here of the water, even if it's you originally put the same volume of water in and you heat one up a lot, it's going to take up more room. In fact, if you boil water, for instance, if you put 100 milliliters of water in a test tube and you boil it, it'll go up to about 104 milliliters. And if you want to know a little bit more about the science background and the activity, in the teacher background portion in the lesson, you can go there. Here is the link right here. And if you're in an NGSS state, we have that performance expectation, MSPS 1.4, develop a model that predicts and describes changes in particle motion, temperature, and state of a pure substance when thermal energy is added or removed. Here's another example. We're further developing this performance expectation. In fact, let's go take a look at the individual dimensions of the performance expectation. Science and engineering practices. Well, kids are developing a model to describe phenomena. They've been doing that already in Chapter 1, Lessons 1 and 2, and now they're doing it in Lesson 3. And they see that in a liquid, the molecules are in constant motion and contact with each other, that matter is made up of particles, that heating them and cooling them has an effect, and eventually we'll see that it causes changes of state. So thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.